Hello everyone, welcome to my class in Fundamentals of Accountancy, Business and Management 2. We have a new topic today, and that is, we will be doing exercises in taxation. If you will look at my whiteboard, I will be illustrating today how to use the graduated tax table in your application of the problem. So everybody, look at my whiteboard. Okay, let us see our problem here. The taxable income is 1 million and we will compute for the tax due. Okay, from our training though, we have studied that there is a new tax table rate or the graduated tax table rate. How do we use the tax table rate? Okay. Be very conscious that we have two tax table rates. One, January 1, 2018 to 2022, and the other one is will be used on 2023 onwards. But the problem is for the taxable year 2020. So we will be using these tax table rates. This column will show us the minimum income. This is the maximum income. These are the tax rates and the tax due plus the additional tax rates in excess over a certain amount. Okay, let's try solving one problem. For example, the compensation income and the taxable income at the same time is 1 million. In order to find the tax due of 1 million, we will look into our tax table where this 1 million Okay, if you will look at your table, it falls right here on this level. Okay, so 800 to 2 million, this 1 million falls on this level. So 800 to 2 million, how much is the tax? 130,000. So this is it. The tax for 800,000 is 130,000. Plus, take note, plus 30% of excess over 800,000. So, this is how we will solve it. We already have taken the 130,000 as the tax due plus 30% of excess over 800,000. Since the taxable income is 1 million, we have to deduct 800,000 from the 1 million because it says 30% of excess over 800,000. So 1 million less the 800,000. So how much is the excess? Correct, 200,000. Then you will multiply 200,000 by 30%. So this is it. 30% of 200,000 is how much? 60,000. Now, we can now get our tax due, 130,000 plus 60,000 is how much? Yes, perfect, 190,000. So,
hello everyone. For today, we will be dealing with exercises in taxation. Okay, but in these exercises, we will be talking about compensation income, business income, mixed income, 8% tax rate, graduated tax rate, the minimis benefit, final tax. And we will be applying these issues in real taxation problems. Okay. For our first slide, I'll be showing again the graduated tax table rates. This is effective January 1, 2018 to 2022. Okay, then the first column shows the minimum income, then the second column shows the maximum level of income, and the third column shows the tax rate. Okay. Next, let's start solving problem 1. It is all about Melissa, as the cashier of XYZ company, has the following payslip. So Melissa is a pure compensation income earner. Why is she considered a pure compensation income earner? Because her source of income is only from her employment. Meaning, you have to test if there is an employee-employer relationship, then we consider Melissa as a compensation income earner. So in this case, her salary is 180,000. Pag-ibig, SSS pag-ibig of 15,000, 13th month pay of 10,000, overtime pay of 10,000, clothing and uniform allowance of 10,000, rice subsidy of 30,000. So we will be applying the principles of mandatory contributions, 13th month pay and other bonuses, and the minimis benefit. How do we apply this? As we compute for the taxable income and tax due of Melissa. Okay, now let's solve. First, we get the total compensation income, which is 180,000. Then we deduct the allowable deductions. And what are the allowable deductions? Number one, the mandatory contributions. Okay, if you are in the government service, that is GSIS. But in this case, it is a contribution to the SSS, pag-ibig, and PhilHealth. So a total contribution of 15,000. So that is considered tax exempt. Okay, so it is deducted from your compensation income. Then 13th month pay, okay, 13th month pay is 10,000. So that is also considered as tax exemption. So 13th month pay plus other bonuses. For example, we have also here, overtime pay is also considered a tax exemption. Clothing allowance and rice subsidy, they are considered as the minimis benefits. And this clothing allowance has, in our law, in the train law, it says the clothing allowance has a limit of 6,000 per annum. But if you look at the problem, I think Melissa is granted a 10,000 clothing allowance. And rice subsidy, she's also granted 30,000 rice subsidy, but what is tax exempt is only 24,000. Okay, so we deduct this from the total compensation income, then we get the total income. And if you will notice, there is an excess of the minimis benefits, the 4,000 coming from the clothing allowance, and the 6,000 coming from the rice subsidy. So that is the excess of the limits of the clothing allowance and the rice subsidy. So 4,000 plus 6 is 10. So we have a taxable income of 125,000. We all know that the train law has exempted minimum wage earners 250,000 and below tax exempt. Did you notice that in our table, 0 to 250,000 has 0 tax rate. So in this case, it's only 125,000. So tax due is 0. There was a question by one of your classmates. Mom, if right at the start of the problem, I noticed that compensation income is 180,000. Well, I still need to compute for the taxable income and tax due. Yes, of course. You have to show to the BIR that indeed Melissa is tax exempt. Because you need to file your income tax return. Okay? Whether you are tax exempt or not. Next. Mixed income earner. So what is a mixed income earner? A mixed income earner, as we have mentioned in our studies earlier, in the past weeks, we mentioned that a mixed income earner is a person who derives income from compensation and from business. And what are the forms of business? It may be business when you engage in a trade or manufacturing or other business, or when you practice your profession. Okay, so compensation income of 1 million plus the gross sales of 2 million and non-operating income of 100,000. So you need to compute for the gross taxable income and tax due. Okay, using the two options, the 8% tax rate and the graduated tax rate. Okay, next, let's start solving this problem 2. Problem 2 is, okay, it's not very clear. It's about, okay, I'll look at the problem. Benito, okay. So, 8% method, okay, if you use the 8% flat tax rate, the gross compensation income of 1 million, you have to refer to your graduated tax table. So, 800,000 to 1 million, is that it? No. 800,000 to 2 million. If you look at your graduated tax table, 800,000 to 2 million has a tax of 130,000. Then, excess over 800,000, you multiply it by 30%. So it's here. 1 million less 800,000 will give you 200,000. Then multiply it by 30% because the graduated tax table says the tax for 800,000 is 130,000. And the tax for the excess over the 800,000 should be multiplied to 30,000. So if the excess is 200, multiply it by 30%, so you get 60,000. So the tax due on compensation is 190,000. Okay, next we compute for the business income. The business income, how much is the business income? 2 million. So it's here, 2 million plus the non-operating income of 100,000. So your taxable business income is how much? 2,100,000. So your 2,100,000 should be what? Multiplied by the tax rate of 8%. So how much will you get? So the tax due on your business is 168,000. Add your tax due from your compensation. So the total tax due from compensation and business is 358. So did you get this right? Also, next, number 3 problem. Oh, again, we will use the same problem, but the method is the graduated tax table. We will use the graduated tax table. So gross compensation income of how much? Of 1 million, okay, gross compensation income of 1 million plus the hardware business of 2 million and 2 million, the 2 million amount has a tax rate, has a tax due of how much? Gross sales, okay, 2 million is 490,000. In excess of 2 million, okay, so 3,100,000 less 2 million will give us how much? 2 million. 1,100,000 multiply it by how much? 32%. So what do you get? 352,000. So the tax due from compensation and business is 842,000. Next. We have here again another problem on the minimis benefit. Melissa, as the cashier of XYZ company, so what problem is that? I'll look for it. Because I can't anymore read from the... So Melissa, where is Melissa? Melissa is the cashier of XYZ company. Okay, so this is pure compensation income earner, 180,000. I think we have solved this already. Not yet. Okay, so her salary is 180, but EBIT contribution of 15, 13th month pay of 10,000, overtime pay of 10,000, clothing and uniform allowance of 10,000 and rice subsidy of 30,000. So, compute for the taxable income and the tax due of Melissa. So, it shows here how to solve the problem. Okay, total compensation of 180,000 plus what? You have to deduct the allowable deductions. The allowable deductions of the mandatory contribution, which is the pag-ibig, SSS, pag-ibig, and funeral, 15,000. 13th month pay of 10,000. So, mandatory contribution is tax exempt. 13th month pay plus other bonuses is 10,000. Up to the limit of how much? 90,000. Please take note. The limit is up to 90,000 only. But since it's only 10,000, then it's still allowed. Okay, then the overtime pay of 10,000, clothing allowance of 6, and rice subsidy of 24. Take note, clothing allowance has a limit of 6,000, though Melissa enjoys a clothing allowance of 10,000, but only 6,000 is tax exempt. And from the rice subsidy, she enjoys 30,000 rice subsidy, but the only tax exempt is 24,000. So if we add all this allowed deduction, then 65,000, deduct it from 180, so you get 115, but you have to add back. You have to add back the excess of the de minimis benefit of 4,000 plus 6,000, so that is 10,000. So the taxable income is 125,000. You will notice that in that 125,000 is tax exempt, because according to our training law, 250,000 and below minimum wage earners are tax exempt. Okay, so 125,000, the tax due is zero. Okay, next. Mixed income earner. Benito has the following data from his business and compensation. Okay, compensation of 1 million. The income from his business is 2 million plus the operating income, non-operating income of 100,000. The same compute for the taxable income and the tax due. Okay, so this is, I can't read it anymore. So this is, okay, this is, who is this? Benito. Okay. Is that problem two? Yes, I think this is it. Benito. So Benito, using the 8% tax method, okay, his income of, how much is his income? Let me go back to the problem again. It's here. Okay, Benito has a compensation income of 1 million. So, 1 million, if you have to refer this 1 million to your graduated tax table. So, 1 million has a tax of 130,000. So, for your 800,000 pesos, it is taxed at 130,000 plus 30% in excess of 800,000. So, 1 million less 800, 200,000 times 30%. So, that is 60,000. So your tax due on compensation is 130 plus 60 is 190,000. Okay. Then the business income is how much? 2 million plus the non-operating income of 100. So it is 2,100,000 is the taxable business income. Multiply it by the 8% tax rate. Okay. So 8%. Times 2,100,000 is equal to 168,000, the tax due on business. Tax due on business plus the tax due on compensation, so it will give you how much? 190 plus 168 will give us 358,000. Okay. Next, we go to, okay, the organization, again from Benito, using the graduated tax table. Okay, when you use the graduated tax table, you have to add because the taxable income from compensation and the taxable income from business, then proceed to compute for the tax rate, then the tax due. Okay, next. So the gross compensation income is 1 million, okay, plus the business income of 2 million plus 100, so 2,100,000 plus 1 million will give us how much? 3,100,000. The 3,100,000, when you look at your graduate tax rate, it will fall on what's this? On 2 million, how much is the tax? 490,000. Excess over 2 million, so 3,100,000 less 2 million, it will give us 1,100,000. Multiply it by the tax rate of how much? 32%. Okay? So times 32%, it will give us 352,000. So your income, your taxable income is how much? 352 plus 490,000 is 842,000. Okay, that is the tax due from income, from compensation, and from business. Next. Again, Jacob, we have another problem here for mixed income earner. Jacob has the following data from his business and compensation income. Okay? 1 million compensation, gross sale 2 million, 90,000 13-month pay plus bonuses, cost of sales 100, operating expense 100, non operating income 100. So there are additional data. Okay, this is a new set of problem. So to solve this problem using the graduated tax rate, okay, the 8% first. We're using the 8% tax rate. Okay, so the gross compensation income of 1 million, you will deduct the allowable deduction of 13th month pay plus other bonuses, a maximum of 90,000. So that is correct. 1 million less 90,000, it will give us 910,000. So that is your taxable compensation income. On 800,000 level, the tax is how much? 130,000. It's here. 130,000. Plus the excess of 800,000. So 910 minus 800, it will give us 110,000. Multiply it by the tax rate of how much? 30%. So it will give us 33,000. 130 plus 33,000 is equal to 163,000. Okay? So that's your tax and tax due from your compensation income. Okay, now let's solve for the business income. From the business income, that is gross sales of 2 million plus your operating income of 100,000. So you get a taxable income of 2,100,000. Multiply it by the flat rate of 8%. Okay? So, flat rate of 8%. So, you get 168,000. So, add your taxable tax due from compensation plus the tax due from business. It will give us how much? 163 plus 168. It will give us 331,000. You notice that when we use the 8% tax rate, you do not deduct the cost of sales and the cost of operating expenses. Okay? The operating expenses and the cost of sales. Why? Because you only base your 8% to your gross income. Okay? It's here. Multiply it by the gross sales plus the operating income, so you get 2,100,000. So it saves a lot of time, because you don't have to be audited for your expenses, for your costs. Okay, so this is a simple way of computing your taxable income and tax due. Now let's use the graduated tax rate. Okay, when using the graduated tax rate, do you notice that you have to add the taxable income from compensation and taxable income from business. Okay, so how much is your gross compensation income? 1 million. You have to deduct the allowable deduction. And what is the allowable deduction? 90,000 from the 13th month, they pay as other bonuses. That's the maximum. So taxable compensation income is 910,000. Now let's go to your business income. Your business income is 2 million. Okay, it's here 2 million. Then you deduct your cost of sales. See, you see the difference from computing this using the graduated tax rate. You have to use the data of your cost of sales. Okay, you deduct your cost of sales, which is 100,000. So your gross income is 1,900,000. Then deduct again the operating expenses. How much? 100,000. So your net income from operations is 1,800,000, but you have to add back the non-operating income of 100,000. So how much is your taxable income? 1,900,000. Then this time, you will add your taxable compensation income to your taxable business income. So it will give us 2,810,000 taxable income from business and from compensation. And from there, we can now use your graduated tax table. Okay, so the tax due on compensation and business is for your 2 million. How much is the tax for the 2 million? That is 490,000. In excess of 2 million, so that is 2,810,000 minus 2 million. So the answer is 810,000. You have to multiply it by the 32% tax rate. So it will give us how much? 810 multiplied by 32, 259,200. So you add the two, the taxable income from what's this? So your taxable income is 490 plus 259,200. So your tax due from business and income is 749,200. So what's the difference here? What did you notice from the computation? You deducted the cost of sales and the cost of operating expenses. While in the 8% tax rate, you did not deduct the cost of sales and the operating expenses, because 8% tax rate is based on the gross taxable income. Okay? Next. Because 8% tax rate is already, what's this? Okay, next we have what problem? Benito has the following data from his shoes and bags business and compensation income. So his compensation income is 1.8 million. Gross sales is 2.7 million. Non-operating income of 100,000. So you compute for the tax due and for the taxable income and the tax due. Compute for the taxable income again using the 8% tax rate. 1.8 million. When you use a graduated tax table, how much is the tax? So of excess over 800,000, the tax for 800,000, the tax is 130,000 pesos. For the excess over 800,000, which is 1 million, multiply it by the tax rate of 30%, so it will give us 300,000. So your tax due on compensation is how much? 430,000. Next, we have the business, the shoes and bag business, using the 8% tax rate. So your gross income, gross sales of 2.7. Add the operating, non-operating income, so total taxable income of 2.8 multiply it with an 8% tax rate, so you get tax due of 224,000. So you add the two, 430,000 tax due on compensation plus the tax due on business, so you get 654,000. Next, mixed income earner, option 2, using the graduated tax table. So when we use the graduated tax table, again, the taxable income of 1.8, okay, when you refer to the tax table, for the 800,000, how much is the tax rate? So 1.8, I'm using here the graduated, okay? So, you add 1.8 taxable income plus your business income, 2.7 plus 100, so it will give us a taxable business income of 2.8 million. So the total taxable income, when you add the 1.8 plus 2.8, it will give us 4.6 million taxable business and compensation income. So if you use your graduated tax table, 4.6 million goes to the level of, so you use this level, the tax for 4 million is how much? 490,000 plus excess over, how much is that? Excess over 2 million. So 4.6 minus 2 million is equal to 2.6. Multiply it by the 32% tax rate. So how much is the tax due? So it is 832,000. So 490 plus 832,000, it will give us a tax due from compensation and business of 1,322,000. Okay, next. SEP, or self-employed individual. Okay, so this is business income. SEP, or self-employed individual or professional, two options to use. Problem 5. Lita has a burger store and gives notarial services in 2018 with the following income. Gross sales from burger store is 800,000. Gross receipts from notarial services is 300,000. So you compute for taxable income and the tax due. So gross sales from the burger is 800 plus the income from the business of 300. So how much is the total sales and receipts? 1,100,000. Deduct the allowable deduction of 250,000 as tax exempt limit. So 250,000. You have to take note that in business income, okay, take note of this. In business income, you are allowed to have a 250,000 tax deduction. Okay? So that is, yes, there is self-employed. Take note again. In self-employed business income, there is a 250,000 allowed deduction for 8% gross income tax rate. Okay, so this is it. So tax exempt of 250,000. So your taxable income is 850,000. So tax due of using the 8% tax rate, so 8% times 850,000 will give us 68,000. Okay, next. Self-employed, so this is a business income using the graduated tax table. So gross sales of 800 plus notarial services of 300 equal to total sales and receipts of 1,100,000. Then the taxable income, if you go into your tax rate table, the tax of 800,000 is 130,000. In excess of 800,000, so 1,100,000 less 800 is equals to 300,000. The tax rate is 30%. So multiply it to 300,000, so you get 90,000. Okay? So 130 plus 90 will give us 220,000 tax due. Okay. Are we following?
Yes. Okay.
Okay, next problem. Problem 6. We're almost done. Problem 6, again, this is self-employed and individual and professional. Bea has a burger store and gives notarial services in 2018 with the following income. So how much is the income? Okay, it was covered in. Okay, what's the name Bea? Bea, where is Bea? Okay. Okay. How much is it? 500. We are now in problem 6. Okay. So 500 plus gross sales and receipts from notarial services of 200 plus the cost of sales of 200,000 and operating expenses of 150,000. So compute for the taxable income. Okay, solution. If you use the 8% tax rate, again, what do you do? Gross sales of 500 plus the gross receipts from notarial services. What is your gross sales and receipts? 700,000. Less the allowed deduction of 250,000. Again, and I have just mentioned earlier, in business income for self-employed individual, you have a deduction of 250,000. So 700 plus 250,000 will give us a taxable income of 450,000. 450,000, multiply it by the tax rate of 8%, it will give us 36,000. So your tax due is 36,000. Okay, next. Again, problem 6, using the graduated tax rate. Okay. When you use the graduated tax rate, that is 500 plus 200, so gross sales receipts of 700 less the cost of sales of 200, so gross income of 500 less operating expense. Oh, take note, in the 8%, we did not deduct the operating expenses and the cost of sales. But there was only a deduction of how much? 250,000. So here, we deducted the operating expenses and the cost of sales. So your taxable income is 350,000. 500 minus 150 is 350,000. You refer to your tax table, 350,000 less 250,000 is 100. 100,000 times 20%. So how much is your tax due? 20,000. Okay, so we now have seen the difference between a graduated tax table and a 8% tax due. Okay, next we have problem 7. Okay, I think this is the last problem. Mario is employed at ABC Trading. Okay, is employed at the ABC Trading. Okay, with the following pay slip. Salary per annum, 120,000, pay 15, 13 monthly of 10,000, overtime pay of 10,000, PCSO winnings of 50,000. Compute for Mario's taxable income and tax due and the final tax. Why final tax? Because of the PCSO winnings. Okay, next. Let's compute the total compensation income of 120,000 less the allowable deductions of mandatory contributions, so that is 15. 13 monthly and other bonuses, that is 10. Then overtime pay of 10, so that is 35,000. 120 less 35 will give us a taxable income of 85,000. Again, 250,000 and below is tax exempt. So tax due is none. Okay? He has nothing to pay. But who is this person? But he won in PCSO. Okay, he won 50,000. Since he won 50,000, PCSO winnings beyond 10,000 as a final tax of how much? What rate? 20%. So you multiply 50,000 by 20%, So your final tax of 10,000 pesos, correct? So I think that's the end of the problem. So thank you very much, and I hope you're able to solve your own problems at all or in your assignments, and you pass it in our Google Classroom, correct? So again, congratulations if you have reached this point or you have already answered your assignments. Again, God bless everyone.